My name is Andrew Thorpe, and I'm at the Jet Propulsion Laboratory. Today I'm going to be discussing our ability to map California's methane emissions using airborne imaging spectrometers. The global methane budget has significant uncertainties associated with the various sources and sinks. Today we're going to be focusing on observing methane point sources from the fossil fuel sectors, as well as agriculture and waste management sectors. One of the benefits of airborne imaging spectrometers is their ability to cover large areas quite quickly to identify methane point sources from different emission sectors. The Avarice Next Generation Imaging Spectrometer was developed at the Jet Propulsion Laboratory. This is a push broom instrument that scans over the surface of the Earth, measuring reflected solar radiation at different wavelengths from 350 to 2,500 nanometers. The methane gas absorption features are shown on the left between 2,100 and 2,500 nanometers, with the strongest absorption features around 2,375 nanometers. So it is these gas absorption features that make methane a greenhouse gas, but it also allows us to generate methane plume images, as shown on the lower right. For each image pixel, we have a quantitative methane retrieval, so we can estimate how many molecules of methane are present above background, and this allows us to estimate emission rates for each plume that was observed. Over the last few years, we've been using Avarice Next Generation to map methane plumes throughout the state of California as part of the California Methane Survey. Here are a few examples of the plumes that were observed as part of that survey. In the upper panel, we've got methane emissions from a gas storage facility, in the center from a dairy, on the right from a wastewater treatment facility. In the second row, we've got an example from a well pad and a landfill on the right. The third panel, an example from a tank in a refinery, and then finally a neighborhood gas leak. Increasingly, we've been sharing our results with facility operators so that they can understand where methane emissions are occurring in their facilities. The example on the left is a plume from the Sunshine Canyon landfill observed in October of 2016. These results, in addition to other snapshots, were shared with the operators. This led to some changes in their land management practices and improvements to their gas capture systems. This ultimately led to a reduction in methane emissions. You can see in October of 2017, the methane plume is significantly smaller relative to 2016. The lower panel shows the correlation between odor complaints from the residents nearby the neighborhood relative to the integrated mass enhancement as measured with Avarice Next Generation. This is an example of a neighborhood gas leak that was identified in real time using an onboard display as part of our routine surveys. A few hours later, we returned to the site, and you can see that the methane plume has shifted relative to the local wind conditions. At the end of the day, we shared these results with the local utility, and they were able to send out our crew the next morning to verify that there was, in fact, a neighborhood gas leak in a road in the Chino Hills neighborhood. This was unknown to the residents as well as the utility, and is a really great example of the ability to identify unknown emissions and share them very quickly for mitigation. These plumes were observed at a gas storage facility in Southern California and are part of a persistent methane emission source that was observed over multiple years as part of the California Methane Survey. Again, you can see that there are shifts relative to the local wind conditions, but the origin, again, is consistent and is associated with an emergency blowdown vent. These results were shared with the local operator of the gas storage facility. After further investigation, they identified a malfunctioning valve and were able to repair this, and in subsequent flights, we were able to verify that the methane plume was gone and the repair was successful. The results from the California Methane Survey were published back in 2019, so I'd refer you to this publication if you're interested in learning more about the work. In parallel, we developed a web-based interface, Methane Source Finder, that allows users to interact with methane data at different spatial scales to better understand methane emissions in California. So let me give you a tour of Methane Source Finder. Let's go ahead and explore the map. The first layer of data that we'll visualize are infrastructure maps of potential methane sources. The Avarice next-gen methane plumes are shown as these purple points, and we have the ability to toggle on and off different layers of data. What I'm showing here is the Los Angeles flux inversion data product that was developed at JPL, and you can see various hotspots throughout the LA Basin as shown in red. Let's go ahead and zoom in to the Chino Hills neighborhood in Los Angeles, where we observe that natural gas leak in a neighborhood. And you can see very clearly a nice base map image to put the methane plumes into a broader context. The methane plume tracks with the local wind conditions, and you can see it, the origin on the road very clearly. If we go to the details page, we can look at additional information associated with the methane plume imagery. We also have emission rates and their uncertainties, the location of the methane plume, and the ability to download plume imagery. So let's go ahead and go back to the map and zoom out and put this information into the broader context of the state of California. And again, you can clearly see hundreds of methane plumes observed with Avarice Next Generation relative to the state of California. So we've been using this tool to better understand methane emissions in California, and we encourage you to check out the site and let us know what you think.